So I've gotten several questions recently about using numbers to find the total of cells that match a certain condition. For instance, here's an example. You have a little list of expenses and you've got different categories like restaurant, market, home, entertainment, and you've got amounts. But say you want to find the total for all of the amounts for the category restaurant. So you've got this one, this one, this one, and for market you've got this one, etc. How can you do that? Well, the trick is to use the SUMIF function. So let's create another table here. I'm going to hit table and create another table. Let's shrink that down. We only need it to be two columns wide. I'm going to stick it right next to this one here. I'm going to call this by category. And it's going to be the category and total as the column headings here. And the first one we want to calculate is the restaurant total. So how will we do this? Well, we're going to use SUMIF. So I'm going to go into formula entry mode. I'm going to hit the equals key is the way I like to do it. Use SUMIF. And I'm also going to search for SUMIF over here. I already have to look it up. Anytime you use a function and you're not really familiar with it, just look it up here so you can see the details. And I can see here a summary of it that it's test values, condition, sum values. And I can scroll more and I could see examples and information and everything. So for SUMIF, the test value is going to come from column B here, or the category column. So I just click there in B and you can see it inserts it. I'm going to hit comma. Now what I want it to compare it to is the word restaurant. So I'm going to do quote, restaurant, quote, and a comma. And then I want it to take the values for adding up for the sum from column C. So I click C over here and it puts in amount because that's the column heading there. Then I'll close the parentheses there. I'll hit the green accept button and you can see it adds up all of the amounts that have a category of restaurant. Now a better way to do this, since I have the word restaurant here in the cell to the left, is instead of using quote restaurant in there, I'm going to replace that with the link to this cell. So that saves me from having to have the word restaurant here and then have it in the formula as well. Now what's cool about that is I can create another row called market and I could copy this cell and paste it here. And if I look at that formula now, instead of A2 it's going to take A3. It advances, since this is one cell down from the original place I copied from, it's going to also move the value here one down. So it's going to be pulling the market instead of the restaurant categories. And I can easily then create home and entertainment. I can copy either one of these two formulas and paste it in each spot. So I get the sums from here. So anytime I add a new category over here, all I got to do is just add it once here on the left and copy and paste that same formula over and I get my totals done automatically. I don't have to retype all that stuff in and create a new formula each time. So that's how you use SUMIF, and it's extremely useful. It's probably one of the most useful and used functions in Numbers or Excel. So it's important if you use spreadsheets a lot to know how to do it, and it solves a lot of problems for a lot of people.